So in this lesson, we'll explore the ways that we can create custom brushes. We'll demonstrate various techniques that you can take and just give you some good tips to help you be able to create your own unique custom brushes. So to start out, when we activate our brush tool, you will notice that we can only paint with one solid color. This seems like a pretty basic concept to understand, but it's really critical to keep this in mind as we create brushes, because as we create them, they are going to basically be created in grayscale format, so that when we paint in one color, they work in that manner. So with that said, we've got some stamps to start out with to start creating brushes. This is probably the easiest way to help you understand the concept. You can use any of your selection tools. Usually for this case, you're either going to use like a rectangular or an elliptical marquee, or you may actually just use like a lasso tool. So in this case, we're going to select one of these stamps so that we can create it as a brush that we can use in Photoshop. Now the way this works is anything that is within this selection that is grayscale, anything that is white will not appear in the brush, and anything that is a gray or black color will be painted in the color that you use your brush to paint with. So with that said, the process is pretty simple. We select first what we want to be our brush. Now you can go in at any point if you decide you don't need all of the selection. Let's say for instance, I didn't want some of that. I could actually deselect it by holding down option. And then if I want to add to the selection, I can hold down plus to add to the selection. Okay, so from there, once you have your selection made, you're going to go to edit, and then you're going to choose Define Brush Preset. Now, if for some reason Define Brush Preset is not here, you do want to take a quick look at your color mode. I have noticed sometimes if your image is like an index color or a different color mode, it may not take the defining of a brush. The other reason why it may not allow you to define a brush is if your image resolution or image size is too large. I believe the max size of a Photoshop brush is about 5,000 pixels. So this is a pretty small brush. It is definitely adequate to be able to create as a brush. So you'll go to the Edit menu, Define Brush Preset, and then it allows us to create, and we'll just name this Stamp London, seeing how there's the word London right there. Okay, and you see it kind of previews the brush for you. Now, as we go and create another document, we're going to be able to use this brush, and you will notice right here where it says 417, that is the pixel resolution that it was created at. So when I paint this, you'll start to notice that it is being painted at fairly small size. Now, in this case, it may be fine to use for a project. However, if you needed it to be larger than that, you may actually try to increase the brush. This is a pretty common thing that I have a lot of students do on accident, and you may notice how blurry and pixelated that looks compared to the other brush. Now, just because Photoshop allows me to increase the size to 2300 does not mean that that is an adequate way to use the brush. So usually what I encourage students to do is if the brush was created at, I believe it was 417, then we don't want to use it any larger than 417. Otherwise, it is going to be a brush that is going to look pretty blurry. So you do have all these different size options. I would not go beyond that max value, even though Photoshop allows you to. So again, that process is pretty simple. You're just going to go through, again, select whatever you want to be your brush, and say Edit, and then Define Brush Preset. Okay, and then we'll say Stamp Roma. And then if we go back again, here's our Roma stamp, and then you can see it's pretty easy to be able to create these. Now these brushes get saved in Photoshop's temporary storage, so we will go through the process of how we save them as well. But we're going to go through a couple more techniques about saving brushes, because it does become a little bit more complicated as we have different things going on. So here's one more example of one that's already black and white. Again, you could select everything inside this brush. We could do a Command A, or you could do a lasso selection. And let's say, for instance, let's deselect real quick. Let's say, for instance, I only want certain parts of this. You know, this is where selecting whatever you want to be in your brush is going to be critical. So any of these selection tools, as we go around selecting, if we do not want something in our selection, we can hold Option, and you'll see that minus sign pops up, and that will subtract it from our selection. Now, if you decided later that you do want it back, you're just going to go back in and add it. Again, anything that is white will not really be saved as a part of your brush. However, if you have any gray values, so you can start to see that this is like more of a gray value, what's going to happen is Photoshop is going to save those as a grayscale value. And so when we paint, it'll paint out a percentage of whatever that value is. Okay, so we're going to go to Edit, Define Brush Preset, and then we'll name this one Splat. Kind of looks like an ink or a blood splat. And then we'll come back over to this document again. And now we have this ink splat that is a fairly decent size that we can paint with. Okay. Again, at any point as you paint, you do have the ability up here to change the percentage of the angle. So if we wanted to be able to paint at a different angle, you can just rotate it. That's a nice feature to be able to get to pretty quickly when we're painting with custom brushes. Now, again, I did mention that the demonstration might get a little bit more tricky. We do have this one here that is, more of a light color watercolor. And so if we were to choose this, and let's just select parts that we want. And you'll see that this is kind of cut off down here, so you may actually have a straight line down there at the bottom. And so we can select it and say Edit, Define Brush Preset. We'll call this one Splat Number 2. Now, if we go back again and paint, and I'll zoom in just a little bit just so that we have a small area of our canvas here to work with. When we paint, you'll start to notice, and I don't know if you guys can see, it's a much lighter color, and then we also have a little bit of the gray values from the paper coming in. And so that's something that you would want to try to alter in Photoshop before you make this brush, if that brush is not turning out as you like. And so usually what I advise students to do is a couple different things. The first thing might be convert it to black and white, so that gives you an idea of the levels of grayscale value that you have to work with. And then you do also have the option here of adjustments, and in your levels adjustments, we have a couple different things here we can work with. First of all, we can add more dark values. We can also add more light or dark values. So if you did want it to paint more solid color, we can push those values. And then we also have these eyedroppers. So if you know that this paper is white, we can actually see if this will turn it more white. And then we could change the values a little bit more. Okay, so as you do go through, it is going to be really critical for you to master what you want this ink splat to look like by the time you're done with it. And then from there, when you're painting with it, you will start to notice that it does have a lot more value to it that you can work with. I have this feeling we're working with a lot of gray values in the background. And then we can just basically, select again. And, you might actually, let's just select just a few of these. And then we can say Edit, Define Brush Preset. And you can see all the gray values in the background. So it may or may not work as well as we want in this instance. So then we have a lot of that gray, And then let's see if I can open one more brush file. So this is actually a watermarked file, so you will see the watermarks pop up, but just an example to convert the black and white again, just as one more example, so we can push it with hopefully not having the background turn as gray. So there's our black and white, and then we are going to go in and add a levels adjustment layer, and we can punch the dark values as much as you desire. And then from there, you would just basically select. Okay, so obviously if this photo wasn't watermarked, we wouldn't have any of those pop up. But just as an example, so you can see how you can alter it. I would encourage, before you get too far though, when you start adding adjustment layers and then you try to save things as brushes, it is smart to just go ahead and flatten that image once you have it how you need it, so that when we go through with this selection, the brush is made as you desire. Sometimes when you keep those adjustment layers, it may not create it quite like what you want. So just go in and deselect. Really rushed selection. We'll subtract that there. And then we'll just say edit, define brush preset. And now when we come back, we have our splat that shows up there. So you notice how this one starts to show with a lot more solid color values versus that very first one that we did that had very light colors. And then this other one that we had done still had a lot of gray values in the background. So that is something that you do need to manipulate in the photo. Now, as we go through, it is going to be really critical for you to know how to save these brushes as well as re-import them. So when you go through with your brush tool, you will basically go up here to your options for these various brushes. We would basically select all of our brushes that we just made, and you'll choose to export them, and then we'll just save them. And now at any point I can delete these brushes because I just saved them. And then we can just import them again to show you that they work. So that ABR file is really critical for you to have in case you ever go to another Photoshop, or in case Photoshop acts up and you have to reboot it and completely reload Photoshop on your computer. These brushes all get stored in temporary storage for Photoshop. So that ABR file is going to be really critical for you to have for various reasons. So you will want to know how to save that. So this is, again, creating custom brushes. There's a lot of cool options. You can make a brush out of just about anything. Just keep in mind the resolution settings, and it does consume your memory. So if you get too crazy with creating brushes, Photoshop might slow down on you. So you do want to keep in mind that they do consume quite a bit of memory if you load a bunch of brushes.